It is surgery day for our Abby today. Fitting that it's pouring rain, so if that's what you hear outside my window right now. It's a good day not to have to go for a walk. That's all I'll say. Yeah, it's pouring rain out there. But we are getting ready to go to the hospital. Luckily, it's same timing for the other girls to go to school. So we are watching the clock and traffic because it gradually increases the closer we get to 8 a.m. When I woke up at 7 a.m., it said traffic was, I think it was like 30 minutes.
Here comes.
Where are they? They're probably in my car in the back seat, in the back of the trunk.
Well, I have to go right there.
Go grab them then. I'll open my trunk. Alright, pick back up here. She can hopefully find her heel cups in my car. So, we are ready. In case you are new here, Abby is having, she is 17. She does not like to be on camera, so I work around that. When we are documenting surgery days, this is her technically third surgery. She's had wisdom teeth out, but she had jaw surgery to reset and restructure her entire face 6 months, 8 months ago, 10 months ago. She had that in December last year. And part of that surgery is that the nose is not in place still. And so the doctor goes in and makes sure there's any structural changes needed in the nose cavity. And then he's doing a deviated septum and giving her the look of a nose that she wants. So I don't know that she's going to let me take a before picture. if she does, you'll see that here. But I don't think we're going to get one. Maybe she'll want to see a before herself. I'm sure she's taken her own photos. So we're gonna head off to the hospital. This is being done at Seattle Children's Hospital, the best hospital in this whole area. So we're very excited it is there. This is where all of her surgeries have been done. It's the same surgeon who's done all of her surgeries. So we totally trust her surgeon and the team. So we're excited to get this part done. This is the last surgery that she'll ever need unless she has an accident or other things in life happen. So we'll bring you guys along the journey. Just remember, I don't film her, as much as possible. I film the journey and the process, but I don't film her necessarily. So just keep that in mind. It's hard to do videos about a person when you can't film that person, but we've managed so far in all that she has gone through. And we're just gonna spend the weekend taking care of her and being together as a family. My oldest daughter, Kaylee, is coming home from college today just for the weekend. And excited to see her probably tomorrow morning. She has plans until super late tonight. So let's go to the hospital.
I saw the end before the movie was done. I got thick skin because I've been burned before. I got baggage that you don't know.
Sanitize our phones. We just got here, getting checked in.
25%.
20 seconds. Abby's phone is in there. We're just gonna get them cleaned up. show us in our OR garb. We don't show Abby. And I got my hairnet on correctly. Let's pull this back a little bit. Super lovely. And now I have my socks. Where's my other sock? Put over flip flops. A little bit ridiculous.
Is that gonna work?
It should.
Yeah, it should. Should work just fine. Is that right? I guess so. With time, you probably think I'm broken. I swear that I'm all right. It's just a little heartbreak, and heartbreak fades with time. You probably think I'm hurting, right? But cowgirls don't. All right, we are going to get out of this. It's been 2 hours since we got here. She's going back.
I don't wish you well.
All right, we are getting some food. We're very hungry. Get some pizza and some fries. All right, Abby has been in surgery for like 40 minutes or so. We went and got some food. Breakfast was kind of over at that point, yeah, so we just had to have pizza. But Jason is on the phone. Let me sneak in here. So we can't go up the elevators or else he'll lose the call. Also, these are kind of cool. They're like full like shower family rooms. So you can like get cleaned up if you're waiting for a long time. He's on the phone with someone else's insurance company. If you guys remember, right after he had hit and run, where they hit the back of his car, someone that we know, one of our friends, hit his door into Jason's door and dinged it. But because it's a Tesla, it's $3,500 of damage to get it fixed. And so that guy has been hemming and hawing and trying to find other places to get it fixed that were cheaper. And he's finally realized I have to just get it done at Tesla. So he's running it through his insurance. Because it's cheaper to pay the deductible than it is to pay for the out-of-pocket. So that's who he's been on the phone with. You done?
Done.
All right, we're gonna go and I've gotta edit and work on my computer while we wait. All right, we've come back to our booths.
I think a lot of people go to the end and then they go to this one.
Yeah, and that has a higher desk. I need that one for my editing. I'm gonna move it over to that chair. This is literally probably where we sat before. Okay, I've got my computer set up here. He's set up over there. And we've got a view. Well, we thought that the surgery started an hour ago. It looks like it just barely started. Everything is going well. So we still have another 3.5 hours to kill. He doesn't know yet. He has his headphones in. Oh well. Literally can't get his attention.
What?
I'm trying to get your attention.
Well, great, then.
Okay, we just got an update. Your child's procedure is finishing up. Check in at the front desk and the doctor will be out shortly. So, we're gonna head out. We both got naps in. He took a nap. I fell asleep sitting up, so I'm waking. we're gonna go over. It's never immediately. If when they say to come check in, the doctor's coming soon. It took like a little while for the doctor to come out last time, so I'm just gonna finish editing really quick. I took a nap instead of finishing this one, so. All right, we've moved to consult room. And as I knew, they were like, yeah, the doctor will be here in about 15, 20 minutes. So yeah, I didn't even put my computer away. I don't have a dongle for that. Hang on. All right, Abby's doing good. We just met with the surgeon and everything went just as he expected it to. They are bringing her out to recovery. He's like easily 20 minutes before they'll call you to go back to her. We're an hour and a half or so before she'd probably even be ready to go home. So But he thinks that she can go home tonight. There shouldn't be any problem.
Yeah, she'll be good.
So we're going to either find a little nibbly to eat. I don't know. We're going to do some more steps back over to the other side of the hospital. And then we'll probably get some food on our actual way home.
Yeah, we'll see. Maybe we get like a smoothie or something now.
That'd be good. Something. We'll go see what they have.
I saw the ending before the movie was done. I got thick skin because I've been burned before. I got baggage that you don't know of.
Okay. I think we're settled in, not for the night, but we have Abby at home. Jason's getting his insurance and information uploaded for his car, because life just doesn't stop, even when you get home from the hospital with your daughter. So, we have only had that one meal today, and I've had a Rice Krispie treat, and only one 20-ouncer cup of water today. So Jason's gonna go get us some Cafe Rio. Kaylee can eat my leftovers this weekend. I just need a good meal, and I'm kind of back and forth helping Abby. So I don't wanna like start making something and, you know, have it get interrupted or burned or anything. So Abby is settled into bed. Obviously she's not gonna have me film where she's at in her room. She's settled into bed. She doesn't need pain meds or oxy for another couple hours. She's gonna let her body kind of settled in. She doesn't want the oxy until she's settled in for the night to go to sleep, because it makes her dizzy, which I have the same side effect when I take it. And so she's just gonna see if she has any pain in the next couple hours. It is 7 o'clock. And she's not due for other pain meds for 2 hours. So she's going to monitor that. She's willing to take it if she's in pain. But we did the last surgery without oxy beyond the hospital. This girl's a tough girl. So there's a good chance we won't need to do the oxy, which the doctor thinks that there's a chance of that too. But we also know our overlap of the other pain meds doesn't exist. So just if you're curious, she has a nose splint cast that goes up over her nose. It's just like a nose surgery. It's just unregular deviated septum. He did do some extra like bone work into the cavity. Did he actually use the cadaver?
Yes.
What is it called? Cadaver
bone cartilage.
Cartilage. Yes. He did use cadaver cartilage in place somewhere in her nose. And then she's got two splints up her nose to keep everything in place while it heals. The incision is on the underside of her nose, so we have to keep some antibiotic ointment on that. And she has nose sprays, two different kinds of nose spray that she does. And then she just drank a Miralax with some juice. She was like, my stomach, I need to go to the bathroom, but it's not working. I'm like, oh, Miralax, let's hurry and get that in you. So she feels a lot better now. She had some ramen soup sitting at her desk. She wanted to sit up to eat that. She felt good to do that. And then just kind of giving you all the things that she's done so far. Grandpa Brown, Jason's dad, he is known for his ice cream drop-offs. But Abby's choice tonight was a frosted lemonade from Chick-fil-A, which he was happy to go and get for her. And luckily it kind of thawed out just a smidge, because Abby cannot have straws for 10 days until the splints come out. I didn't know that. I mean, I guess I just didn't think about it because nose, mouth, I just didn't make the connection. So luckily the lemonade had thawed out just a smidge. So we put that into a metal like water bottle with a lid on it. We're kind of doing everything with that so she doesn't have a straw. She has her own Awala bottle, and so she just has to pour it in. In fact, I should take out the straw. so she's not tempted to suck on it. But so yeah, the frosted lemonade was melted enough. She's able to just kind of pour it and drink it that way. So we're kind of set up for the night. I think it's going to be a little bit of a long night just to make sure she's, you know, the pain meds happen in a couple hours, but our bedroom is just down the hall from her. She texts me or calls me if she needs something, so it shouldn't be a big deal. So done. We are done with surgeries with her. So we're glad to be home. I'm probably going to end with you guys just so that I can be focused on her and resting myself. I need to edit and get that stuff done so that I can just take care of her when she's kind of awake and maybe she wants to come downstairs tomorrow afternoon. Kaylee is, I thought she would be here. I don't know if she's going to come here.
Be nice if she did.
I know, I told her to. She didn't want to stress us out, but I told her it wasn't going to be stressful. It looks like she's at Jacob's. Oh, she's just barely. Is she coming to our house? Where's she at? No, she's going to Jacob's. Maybe she's dropping him off. She's dropping, I don't know. She's going to Jacob's house first. So she's here in town. If she finds out I have Cafe Rio or I'm getting Cafe Rio, you could probably bribe her and have her come and get it, Jason.
I will.
So we're going to sign off with you. This is more of a montage-y day kind of video just because, you know, it's very quiet at the hospital. So I don't like to pick out the camera and talk too much, but, so we're glad that this part is done. Recovery isn't too bad. She's just going to swell up. The doctor said that she's just got sensitive, really thin, clear skin, and it's just going to show every bruise. He's like, she's going to be black and blue and swollen. So she has clearance from school for 2 weeks if she wants to stay home. If she's embarrassed by it or not feeling comfortable, the splint does stay on for 10 days. So she's free to stay home. I'm sure she could get caught up with the schoolwork. She'll be in contact with her teachers. So I'm not worried about it. She'll stay on top of things. Because if anything, she's just staying home because she's just kind of embarrassed that it's swollen or whatever. So she'll be functioning to get her homework done. So we're going to sign off with you guys. We're glad that it's all done, taken care of. And let's just hope and pray in 2 years that Ashley does not have this genetic disorder. Oh, fun thing that we realized. The anesthesiologist who came in to do her surgery, she was like, I've been your doctor before. And we were like, not for the jaw surgery. She's like, I was here 2 years ago for your other surgery. And I was like, oh, wisdom teeth. And I was like, you had a baby 2 years ago. And she's like, oh my gosh, you remember that? Because we'd been, and then we were talking about, so she has a 2.5-year-old now and almost 3. And so we were talking about how I've realized the personalities of my babies match how they came into the world. Like their labor story and the personality that they had, like the personality of the labor and delivery completely matches their personality as they've grown up. So she was like, okay, let me think this through. I've never heard of anyone talk about this. So she described her oldest daughter's childbirth. And then like, you could see like little light bulbs going on. She's like, that totally fits her. Her delivery was calm and collected and I went on time and da da da. And then the second, her second baby, chaos. She was like, oh, it was chaos. She was sunny side up. And she was like, and she's a little devil. She's like, that's so interesting. So it was kind of fun that she remembered Abby and, well, she probably just saw it on the chart that she was Abby's doctor. 2 years ago. She's like, you guys get around this hospital, don't you? And I was like, well, unfortunately, when it comes to children's hospital, that's kind of a thing. Unfortunately, there's a lot of sad kids today at the hospital that we saw. So it's not exactly the funnest place to be, but we're glad to have the opportunity to have the surgery there and have the doctors take care of Abby so well. Like her surgeon, I could cry.
literally could cry with how much we absolutely love and adore her surgeon so well, so much. But we're gonna say goodnight to you. Take care. Wish Abby luck as she recovers now, and we'll see you guys next soon.
Think I'll let it be.